Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. This is a pathology video on respiratory pathology. This is the second in the series of videos on tuberculosis and it covers the topic types and morphology. This is presented by Dr. CSBR Prasad, Professor of Pathology, Sri Devrajaras Medical College.
And to elaborate more on primary tuberculosis, seen as an initial infection, especially it is seen in children, and the usual location of this primary tuberculosis is the lung, wherein you will see subpleural granulomas with hilar lymphadenopathy. So fate of this primary tuberculosis is self-containment and healing by fibrosis or calcification. Rarely, this primary tuberculosis can progress to progressive variety of primary tuberculosis. This slide shows the cut surface of the lung involved in this primary tuberculosis, wherein you are seeing the yellowish nodule subjacent to the pleura and one more yellowish nodule at the hilum. So this yellowish nodule is the primary focus, and this one is the yellowish nodule, that is caseous necrosis involving a hilar lymph node. So in between there will be what is known as the lymphatics draining this area to the lymph node, and the inflammation also affects this lymphatics. So there will be subpleurally located granuloma with lymphangitis and hilar lymphadenopathy. You can see that subpleurally located caseous granuloma, and this arrow pointing to the hilar lymph node. And this combination of the Gons focus, the lymphadenitis, hilar lymphadenitis, and in between the lymphangitis constitutes the components of Gons complex. The same thing, closer view, you can appreciate the yellowishness imparted to this cut surface of these areas. It is due to caseous necrosis. So the other important points you should remember is there are five sites for primary tuberculosis to occur. So it is lung, GIT, skin, tonsil, and the lymph node. And apart from these five sites, tuberculosis occurring in other sites of the body, most of the times it is what we call secondary variety of tuberculosis. So coming to secondary variety of tuberculosis, that is, it is known as reactivation tuberculosis or reinfection tuberculosis. That means the person already got exposed to tuberculosis bacilli, got sensitized, and such persons react to the exposure for the second time in a different way. So it is most commonly seen in adults. Focus of infection is the upper lung lobes, and fate is the progressive form of tuberculosis with cavitation, and sometimes it may be associated with miliary spread. So here this slide shows the cut surface of the lung involved in secondary variety of tuberculosis. All these gray white areas what you are seeing in this lung field is are the granulomas, and here this is a bigger area which can which is showing that caseous type of necrosis. Most of these gray white areas are confined to the upper portions of the lung. So this is the typical appearance or affection in secondary variety of tuberculosis. So this slide shows the cross section in a closer view of the same lung. Here you can see, appreciate the presence of gray white nodules of different sizes, and this one is a bigger one. You can see this yellowishness imparted because of caseous necrosis. All these gray white nodules are mainly concentrated on the apical portions of the lung. And this gray yellow areas due to caseous necrosis, and caseous necrosis typically equated with tuberculosis infection, but sometimes you may come across caseous necrosis in histoplasmosis, coccidiomycosis, and also sometimes in tertiary syphilis, that is gammatous syphilis, may show caseous necrosis. And again here the little advanced lung affection, wherein the caseous material has been thrown out in the sputum, and you are seeing the necrosed areas converted into cavities. So cavitatory necrosis is typically seen to be associated with this type of tuberculosis. So the X-ray view, you can appreciate the yellow areas pointing to the periphery or margin of the cavity in the upper lobe. And again, the same thing, you must appreciate the presence of cavities here. And this is the cross section of the lymph nodes, multiple lymph nodes involved in this tuberculosis. You may see the each lymph node distinctly, but they are attached to each other. You will call this as matting of lymph nodes. And some of these lymph nodes show yellowish discoloration at the center. So this is called as caseous necrosis, or cheesy or cheese-like appearance of this necrotic material. And this is very typically seen in the case of tuberculosis infection. And a word about cold abscess. Extensive caseous necrosis involving the lymph nodes, especially cervical region of the lymph nodes, may be associated with liberation of the contents, necrosed material, into the surrounding soft tissue, which produces a softness or soft swelling which resembles an abscess, but the signs of inflammation are completely absent. That is the reason why it is known as cold abscess. So this is a clinical case wherein there is a swelling which is yielding pus. This is yielding pus, and look at this skin towards the swelling. It is not red. That is the reason why it is known as cold abscess. And other causes for matted lymph nodes, which you should know, is the lymphomas. Apart from tuberculosis, lymphomas also can produce matting of the lymph nodes. Basis for this matting is periodontitis or capsular infiltration in the case of lymphomas. So this infection or the neoplasm spreads beyond the capsule and infiltrates the surrounding lymph node, producing clinically you can detect that these two or three lymph nodes matted or combined together to produce a mass. So it is called as matting, which is very typically seen in tuberculosis and lymphomas. Coming to the microscopic features of tuberculosis, epithelial granulomas are characteristically seen in this tuberculosis infection and with the giant cells. So among the giant cells, Langerhans type of giant cells more frequently encountered, even though it is not very specific for tuberculosis. And this epithelial granuloma shows lymphocytic infiltration around them. And caseous necrosis can be appreciated at the center. Caseous necrosis resembles a powdery eosinophilic material at the center. If you do Jaden stain or Jean Nielsen stain on these sections, probably you may demonstrate the bacilli. So these bacilli occur in doublets. They are usually occur in pairs at an angle, and they are usually beaded. So these are the very typical features of tuberculosis bacilli in Jaden stain. So this is a lung section. Even you can appreciate the presence of multiple granulomas. Closer view will show you the presence of Langerhans type of giant cells in these granulomas. Still closer, you can appreciate the caseous necrosis, especially at the center. So this is the caseous necrosis. You can see the powdery eosinophilic material at the center of these granulomas, and this is Langerhans type of giant cell. So Langerhans type of giant cell, at a closer view, the nuclei are located at the periphery of this giant cell, and at this periphery of this granuloma, you'll see the lymphocytic infiltration. Jaden stain will demonstrate the acid post bacilli, which are pink or red in color. So multiple bacilli which are rod shape can be appreciated in this slide. So sometimes this tuberculosis can spread systemically in a fashion which are called as miliary tuberculosis. So this spread of tuberculosis is associated with production of granulomas which are smaller, and they resemble the millet seeds, hence the name miliary tuberculosis. So miliary tuberculosis can be systemic miliary tuberculosis or pulmonary variety of miliary tuberculosis. So this slide shows the cut surface of the lung. You can appreciate the presence of gray-white nodules spread across the lung field, and they are of uniform size. They are resembling the millet seeds, so hence the name miliary tuberculosis. Closer view, you can appreciate that gray-white nodules of uniform size. That is very important, and that means this infection spread at the same time. So they grew to produce similar size nodules. And again, at closer view, to show that gray-white nodules resembling millets. And the systemic miliary tuberculosis occurs when the focus of caseous necrosis ruptures into pulmonary vein, spreading systemically. And this miliary tuberculosis can be confined only to the lung when the focus of caseous necrosis ruptures into the pulmonary artery or lymphatic vessel within the lung fields. And sometimes patients may land in the production of pus or pus within the pleural cavity. We call this empyema. And these cavities produced by tuberculosis may form a nidus for the growth of this fungus known as Aspergillus. Aspergillus colonize these cavities and produce masses, and which in the X-ray may resemble a tumor. So here you can see one fungal nodule, Aspergillus nodule, producing a shadow which is radio opaque and which may resemble lung tumor. But notice the appearance of a crescent, that is dark shadow, over this radio opaque shadow. So this is a crescent sign, which is very typical of pulmonary aspergillosis. And when you move the patient, again take an X-ray, this shadow shifts. This is very typical sign that can give a clue regarding the presence of aspergillosis organism within the cavity of the old pulmonary tuberculosis. The same thing, cavity showing bluish filamentous structures within the cavity. And again, here you can see that hyphal forms are very clear.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe by clicking the button subscribe.